the biggest piece of advice I can give to anyone starting out or trying to start out is just ask.
Mm.
Ask. That's what gets you the opportunity. And I mean, I already kind of had, you know, it with the industry, so to speak, for 7 years. I just felt like a lot of restaurants were kind of disrespectful, or managers were. And then this one really did it for me. And I said, you know what? I'm never, ever going to work for a restaurant again. This is where I start to, you know, start looking at a career. Because this isn't a career. Mm-hmm. Career will let you advance. Mm-hmm. The restaurant won't.
How did you meet Don?
How did I meet Don? It's the classic Facebook. Mm. Facebook, but I was looking to, you know, start to network with people. He popped up and click, I requested him.
He was a suggestion?
He was a suggestion.
Don't you like Facebook suggestions sometimes? You're like, why would you suggest them?
Right? I mean, look at his picture. I was like, it's not a bad suggestion, Facebook.
I'll take it.
Click. Honestly, my favorite quote is by Dr. Seuss. And you know what he said? You have to be odd to be number one.
Mm.
You have to be odd to be number one.
Mm.
And that, it, you know, it really makes you think, you're like, wow. I mean, even if you look at like Elon Musk or Jeff Bezos, if you really took a look at them, aside from their money, you think they're pretty freaking weird, right?
Weirdos.
But weird isn't bad. So mom, you know, telling me that I don't really have any skills, you know, hard to hear, definitely sucks. Now, not maybe not at the time, but now I realize, you know, it's all out of love. It was just kind of, you know, her way of, you know, trying to guide me.
Mm.
Definitely motivated me to be like, you know what? And she kept telling me, just take a restaurant job. It's what you know. It's all you know. And I'm like, no, I'm not going to do it. I'm not going to take it because it's all I know. Because I know I can do something else. I don't know what and how, but I know there's more for me out here. It's not just doing that. My mom's always trying to give me this advice about social media. Nobody cares. You know, why are you doing that? Yeah, you know, all this stuff. People judge. While she's true to some regard, she, you know, I cannot take the advice of someone who doesn't even have social media themselves.
Hmm.
You know? So that was another lesson I kind of learned. Like, don't take advice from people that aren't practicing or doing anything themselves with it. And I've had to block some people on the social media as well from family.
Me too.
Just from, you know, negative feedback for no reason.
I don't need this.
Yeah.
I always block them and I report them. Even if they didn't do anything wrong.
And I report them.
Report, hate speech, other, like.
Yeah.
So they get, like, pushed off for 3 days. Facebook jail.
Facebook jail. You watch all these iconic people talk about it, right? Talk about what you gotta do. But the first step I had to take was auditing my friend group.
Yeah.
100%. I mean, I had to audit the hell out of myself. But, so I guess audit yourself and then audit your friend group. What you look at every day is going to be kind of indicative of your mindset for that day. So I hate having anything negative on my newsfeed. So even if it's, I have friends that I'm friendly with that I delete off Facebook just because of the negative stuff they post.
You ask, you talk, you stick your neck out there. That's how you met me.
That's true.
It wasn't from sitting quiet.
Oh yeah, why don't you tell people how we met?
It was, she was on Craigslist.
Classic Craigslist.